Alphonse Daudet, a renowned French author, playwright and poet, started writing poems and stories when he was 14. Daudet's works are known for their realistic portrayal of life and human emotions. Several of them reflected his own experiences. Some of his notable works include the short story collections Letters from My Mill and Monday Tales, and the novels Tartarin of Tarascon and Froment and Rizla. Daudet enlisted in the army during the Franco-Prussian War, and the influence of this experience is evident in the stories in Monday Tales. The last lesson, which is from the collection, is set against the backdrop of France's loss in the war. It revolves around the impact of this loss on life and schooling in the Alsace region of France. Through the recollections of a young Alsatian schoolboy, it reveals how deeply intertwined language is with national pride and identity. Here is a summary of The Last Lesson by Alphonse Daudet. Franz, the narrator of the story, was running late for school one day and was worried about getting a dressing down from his teacher, Monsieur Hamel. He had not learnt the rules of French participles like Monsieur Hamel had asked them to. As Franz hurried to school, he noticed a crowd in front of the village's bulletin board. Since he was already late for school, Franz did not stop to read the news. When he reached school, Franz couldn't hear the usual bustling sounds heard at the beginning of a school day. The stillness worried Franz even more, as he had hoped to slip in unnoticed in the commotion. Franz entered the classroom embarrassed and afraid, but was surprised when Monsieur Hamel kindly asked him to take his seat. It was only after he sat down that Franz noticed that Monsieur Hamel was dressed in clothes that he wore only on important days like inspection or prize days. There was a strange solemnness in the air. What surprised Franz even more was the sight of villagers occupying the back benches that would otherwise be empty. As Franz wondered what was happening, Monsieur Hamel informed them in a grave tone that this would be their last French lesson. Since Germany took over Alsace and Lorraine after the war, it had been ordered that only German would be taught in schools. Franz was shocked by the announcement and realized why the atmosphere was so serious that day. He was filled with regret and wished he had paid more attention to his studies instead of fooling around. His books no longer felt like a nuisance, and he realized he would miss the cranky old Monsieur Hamel. Then he heard his name being called out for recitation. Completely unprepared, Franz made several errors as soon as he began and stood there feeling terribly ashamed. Again, instead of scolding Franz, Monsieur Hamel spoke about the general tendency in the village to put off learning. The Prussians could now mock them for not knowing to speak and write their own language. Monsieur Hamel went on to say how it was not just Franz's fault. Franz's parents were guilty too, for they preferred that he work on a farm or at a mill than attend school. Monsieur Hamel confessed that he himself acted irresponsibly when he gave students holidays so that he could go fishing. Monsieur Hamel then spoke about how French was the most clear and logical language and how they must guard the language. By doing so, they would have retained at least one part of their freedom. While they continued with the lessons for the day, Franz found himself paying attention to every word that Monsieur Hamel uttered. Monsieur Hamel, too, taught with a zeal like never before. At one point, Franz looked up from his work and saw Monsieur Hamel gazing at everything as if he was trying to take a mental photograph of everything he could see. It was a deeply emotional moment for Monsieur Hamel to leave behind 40 years of hard work. Even the villagers seemed to be overcome with emotion. Finally, when the lesson ended, Monsieur Hamel stood up to speak, but words were stuck in his throat. He only managed to write "Vive la France" on the blackboard and dismissed the class with a wave of his hand. The main characters in the last lesson are Monsieur Hamel, a French teacher with 40 years of experience, and Franz, a student. Some villagers feature briefly in the story too. Click each label to learn more about the characters. Monsieur Hamel comes across as a very strict and grumpy teacher who doled out punishments if students wouldn't learn their lessons. This is evident at the beginning of the story when the narrator is afraid of going to school and facing Monsieur Hamel without having done his homework. The narrator also mentions the teacher's terrible iron ruler. Monsieur Hamel is a committed person. He had taught at the village for 40 years until the new government's ruling forced him to leave. His faithfulness to his job is partly the reason some villagers attended his last class. There were instances where he chose fishing over his work, but this easygoing attitude seems to be indicative of the way of life in the village. Monsieur Hamel is patriotic and had great love for his country and language. During the last class, he calls French the most beautiful, clearest, and most logical language in the world. He urges his students and the villagers to guard their language at any cost. At the end of the class, he writes the message "Vive la France," that is, "Long live France," in big letters on the board. Franz is the narrator of the story, and we see the events of Monsieur Hamel's last lesson through his eyes. Franz comes across as a carefree individual who preferred spending his time outdoors rather than within the four walls of a classroom. He had little interest in studying and felt that his books were a nuisance. Franz is regretful when he realizes that he wasted the opportunity he had to receive a proper education. He wishes he had spent more time on his books instead of hunting for birds' eggs or sailing on the Saar River. Now let us examine the story closely. The last lesson is set around 1873 in a town in Alsace, France. Alsace, along with the neighboring Lorraine, had been annexed by Prussia after France's loss in the Franco-Prussian War. Using this setting, Daudet artfully brings out the anguish that comes with the loss of freedom. The dominant theme of the last lesson is the love for one's country and language. This is evident from everyone's response to the ruling from Berlin. Along with the children, adults too participate wholeheartedly in Monsieur Hamel's last class. In fact, everyone is extremely emotional at the thought of French no longer being a part of the school lessons. Franz regrets not having taken his French and history lessons seriously. The theme comes out most obviously from Monsieur Hamel's actions. For instance, he talks about the beauty of the French language. The copies he gives out has "France Alsace" written on them. Finally, when the bell rings, Monsieur Hamel writes "Long live France" on the board. Closely linked to the theme of patriotism is that of language and identity. For all social groups, their language is closely linked to their identity. Therefore, the loss of one's language is akin to the loss of identity. Because of the ruling that replaced French with German in schools, the people of Alsace felt as if they were being asked to give up who they are. Hence, Monsieur Hamel's last class was before a packed classroom, including not just children, but also adults. The significance of language and identity is brought out powerfully through Monsieur Hamel's comment that people have the chance of escaping enslavement if they preserve their language, for language is like a key that will help them get out of the prison. Though not the predominant theme of the story, The last lesson beautifully illustrates the importance of taking education seriously. As Monsieur Hamel puts it, the problem with Alsace was that she puts off learning till tomorrow. Parents preferred it if their children worked on farms or at mills and contributed to the household income. Children whiled time away instead of studying. Monsieur Hamel too was guilty of neglecting his duty so that he could pursue his hobby. Because they took things for granted, they were now in a situation where they were not proficient in their own language and couldn't learn it further. Thus, the story urges us to seize the opportunity to learn when we have it.